Yes.
No scope.
What is going on, guys? This is Spade, and this is going to be a video regarding the topic of 60 frames per second, and does it really matter? And the reason why that saying is because some of the videos I watch on YouTube that are in 60 FPS don't really look like they should be in 60 FPS, you know, like car videos and stuff like that. Some of the gaming stuff I can see as being 60 FPS, whereas other stuff I don't really see that big of a need, because there's not a lot of games that actually are 60 frames per second, so it doesn't really benefit me that much. I still find myself watching, I use a lot of different browsers, whereas Google, if it's 60 FPS, it'll automatically play it in 60 FPS, but if I use Firefox or whatever, it's 30 FPS, and it doesn't really bother me. And for a video to truly be 60 frames per second, it has to be recorded in 60 FPS, rendered in 60 FPS, and uploaded in 60 FPS. Now, my Gymkhana Civic video was recorded in 60 FPS and rendered in 60 FPS, but for whatever reason, it only uploaded in 30. I'm not sure why. But this is just one of those things where I feel that 60 FPS videos can benefit for Call of Duty and shooters and stuff like that, if they are a native 60 FPS game or a PC game where you actually can get above that frame cap. This is some Modern Warfare 2 gameplay on PC, so you'll notice it is a little bit higher fidelity than it was on console and stuff like that. Gameplay is not super impressive. This is probably the first time I played Modern Warfare 2 on PC in easily about 3 months, and I think I went 20-3 or something like that. I mean, it's not anything impressive by any means. But I want your guys' opinions on the whole 60 FPS thing. Is it really that big of a deal for you? Because even whenever you go in and you watch movies or anything like that, it's actually a 24 frames per second. So any cinematic feel things isn't even in a 30 FPS. It's 24. So if you have a TV and your TV is, say, 120 hertz TV, which is a lie, because most TVs only go up to HDMI inputs, which can only output 60 frames per second. But they have little programs and, you know, beepity boops in there that add frames in between frames, which gives it that smooth motion effect, you know. So it's not a true 120 frames per second. And it gives it that soap opera motion blur thing. And I just don't really like that at all. So anyways, like, what's the average viewer base? So 60 FPS matter to you on a YouTube video? To me, it really doesn't. It's just like watching a 4K video. A 4K YouTube video isn't going to benefit me at all. Whereas other people are like, oh man, I could record in 4K. Okay, you're going to upload it in 4K, but hardly anyone's going to be able to watch it in 4K. Now, granted, the people that have the ability to watch it in 4K, I'm sure will enjoy it. But the amount of bandwidth that it takes to watch in 4K, the monitor and everything else required for that, not everybody's going to be able to do that. And even me, to this day, I don't even really record videos and render them in 1080p. Like, I play in 1080p and I record in 720p and I render in 720p. Just because, honestly, it's just easier for me. It's easier to upload and render a 720p video than it is a 1080p video. But that's just because my bandwidth sucks. Now, if that changes, when that changes in January, it might be a different story. But that's it, guys. Does 60 FPS matter for you? Let me know in the comments section below. Later.